Hey guys, Mark here. I hope you're all doing well. In this video, I'm going to show you how to tie a triangular mat which can be used as a hotbed for your tables, as a coaster, or any other type of a mat. The mat is fast and easy to tie. Let's move on. Here you can see an example of a triangular mat, and I used a 1/4-inch cotton rope for this project. You can use other materials, such as hemp or any others that you might have at hand. As far as the length of the rope goes, the bare minimum was 10.5 feet for a 3-pass version. I would recommend 11 or 12 feet just to make things easier to tighten. Now, when we're preparing our rope, we need to do two things. One is to secure the ends of our rope, which we do either by whipping them, like you see here, or just using some tape and taping our ends up and preventing them from unraveling. The other thing that you can do, if your rope frays a bit, like this hemp rope, is to wax it, which will make it smoother and easier to work with. With that said, let's start our tutorial. Here I have my rope, which I folded in half. I'm going to pick up the right end and make a loop at the top. This is going to be the top point in our triangle. I'm now going to move to the bottom right and create a bite. Like this. Then I'm going to move to the bottom left and create a loop. Like this. I'm going to travel under the standing end like this, and we have the 3 points of our triangle. We're now going to weave through the top loop, going over under then go over the bite on the bottom right, then weave through it, going under, over, then under. Then weave through the loop on the bottom left, going over under. And finally, place your working end next to the standing end, like this, and this finishes a single pass of our mat. Now, follow your standing end with your working end until you run out of rope. Then do the same with the standing end. Once you run out of rope in both of your ends, it is time to re-tighten your mat until you get a smaller, more compact mat. I now have about 2 passes in my mat, and I want 3, so I'm going to need to pull out the slack and use it to make a 3rd pass. Once you have tightened your mat, this is how it should look like. It is pretty much done, and on the bottom side of it, both ends of your rope should meet at the same location. I take a further step in my mat making by stitching together both ends just to prevent my mat from unraveling in any situation. Now I'm going to show you how to do this, and you're going to need a needle as well as a thread. On the other side of my thread, I made an overhand knot. And after threading my needle, we can begin. I'm going to start on my 2nd pass here and go up like this. Then move down through all of your passes. Then up again going through all of your passes. Pull firmly. Then go down. Two sections or two passes. And at this point you can lock off your stitch by basically making a loop. Like this. And then placing your thread into it. I do it two times for safety reasons. And then I run my end to the bottom again. Like this. At this point, I would cut the end of my thread, and we have a stitch mat. Guys, thank you for joining me in this tutorial. I hope it proved useful. Thank you and see you next time.